Hi dear students, welcome to the classes. Today I will start a next concept that is called chemical properties of halogens and halorines. You see, we learn all things about halogens and halorines. First introductions, preparations, next physical properties, next concept we are going for the chemical property of halogens and halorines. What is mean by chemical property? Chemical property of halogens and halorines means that these halogens and halorines are reacting, how they are reacting with the other chemicals. And what is the which type of reactions involved in these halogens and halorines we are learning in this headline, subheadline. That is called chemical properties. Therefore, in this chemical property, these halogens and halorines involved in the different type of reactions. These reactions we named as nucleophilic substitution reactions, elimination reactions, next one is called as reactions with metal. Therefore, these halogens and halorines are involved in these three types of reactions: nucleophilic substitution reactions, next elimination reactions, and reactions with the metal. Therefore, now we have to study one by one. That's why first we have to go for nucleophilic substitution reaction. What does mean by nucleophilic substitution reaction? We go for first one. What is mean by nucleophilic substitution reactions in halogens and halorines? This nucleophile. This what is mean by nucleophile? We know first we come to know for this. Nucleophile means these are the species. These are the species with negatively charged ions, or it may be molecules. Therefore, they are called as nucleophile. Example. This is what X minus, OH minus, CN minus. These are all nucleophile. This nucleophile involved in the reaction. Therefore, they are called as nucleophilic substitution reaction. What is mean by substitution? Substitution reactions means that these are the type of chemical reactions in which we have to add one function, one of the any group by replacing the other present group. We see here from this example we got come to know that. For example, this is what halogens and halorines. In this halogens and halorines, we have to add the nucleophile. This is what we have to remove this halogens and add this nucleophile to this carbon. Therefore, the replacement of one halogen atom and addition of nucleophile. Replacement and addition. In that replaced place only, we have to add one more molecule. That is called mustard should be nucleophile. Therefore, we are substituting one molecule by another molecule. So therefore, such reactions are called as nucleophilic substitution reaction. Therefore, we are replacing this. Therefore, this is in this X place, means halogen place, we are adding to the nucleophile. Therefore, such reactions are called as, and also this X minus is going outside. This is what a nucleophilic substitution reaction. This nucleophilic substitution reaction takes place. Must and should be two conditions. One must and should be this is weak or it is strong. Must and should be halogens is weak or it may be strong. If it is not weak, we have to apply some conditions externally to make it as weak or it go to easily it is leaving group. We have to make it easily going outside. Easy leaving group ಆಗಿ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ನಾವು ಇದನ್ನ. ಈಸಿಲಿ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಆಗಿ ಮಾಡಿದ್ವಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಅವಾಗ ಈಸಿಲಿ ಹೊರಗೆ ಹೋಯ್ತು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನಾವು ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯೋಫೈಲ್ ಅನ್ನು ಈಸಿಲಿ ಆ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಅಟ್ಯಾಚ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಆ ಕಾಂಪೌಂಡ್ ಅನ್ನು ಪ್ರಿಪೇರ್ ಮಾಡಬಹುದು ಅಥವಾ ನಾವು ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯೋಫೈಲ್ ಅನ್ನು ಅಟ್ಯಾಕ್ ಮಾಡಬಹುದು. ದೇರ್ಫೋರ್ ಸಚ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ನಾವು ಏನು ಕರ್ತೀವಿ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯೋಫಿಲಿಕ್ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಷನ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಕರ್ತೀವಿ. ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ವಿ ಸಿ ಹಿಯರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಮಿಥೈಲ್ ಕ್ಲೋರೈಡ್. ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಮಿಥೈಲ್ ಕ್ಲೋರೈಡ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಆಡಿಂಗ್ NaOH. ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್ ದಿಸ್ OH ಮೈನಸ್ N, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯೋಫೈಲ್. This nucleophile attacking to this methyl and this carbon is going outside. Therefore, this is what CH3OH plus NaCl is going outside. Therefore, in this reaction, what happens? This is a nucleophile attacking to this carbon and this is Na plus and Cl minus. Therefore, NaCl is going outside as a byproduct. Therefore, in this what happens? Nucleophile attack to the carbon atom. Therefore, they are called as nucleophilic substitution reactions. There are so many reactions are there. 1 minute. Next, this is what are reactions in which the nucleophile is attacking. For this example, we are coming understanding this nucleophilic substitution. This nucleophile, ನೋಡ್ರಿ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯೋಫೈಲ್ ಅನ್ನು OH ಮೈನಸ್ ಒಂದೇ ಅಂತಲ್ಲ, ಯಾವುದೇ ಆಗಿರಲಿ ಈ OH ಮೈನಸ್ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೋದು. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಲೈಡ್ಸ್ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೋದು, ಅದರ್ವೈಸ್ ಸಿ ಎನ್ ಮೈನಸ್ ಆಗಿರಬಹುದು, ಅದರ್ವೈಸ್ ಎನ್ ಓ ಟು ಮೈನಸ್. ಆಲ್ ದೀಸ್ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯೋಫೈಲ್ ಅಟ್ಯಾಕಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದಿಸ್ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್, ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ ರಿಪ್ಲೇಸ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದೀಸ್ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯೋಫೈಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಎಡಿಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಮ್ ಅದರ್ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯೋಫೈಲ್, ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯೋಫಿಲಿಕ್ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಷನ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್. ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಸೋ ಮೆನಿ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯೋಫಿಲಿಕ್ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಷನ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್. ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಸೋ ಮೆನಿ, ಯು ಸಿ ಹಿಯರ್, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಮೆಥಾಲ್ ಕ್ಲೋರೈಡ್. ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಮೆಥಾಲ್ ಕ್ಲೋರೈಡ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಆಡಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದಿ ವಾಟರ್, ದ ವಾಟರ್ ಕನ್ಸಿಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಓ ಎಚ್ ಮೈನಸ್ ಆಸ್ ಎ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯೋಫೈಲ್, ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ ಇಟ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಟು ದಿ ಮೆಥನಾಲ್, ಮೆಥನಾಲ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಎಚ್ ಸಿ ಎಲ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಗೋ ಫಾರ್ ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್. ಇಫ್ ಪೊಟ್ಯಾಶಿಯಂ ನೈಟ್ರೇಟ್ ಎನ್ಓ ಟು, ಇಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಎನ್ಓ ಟು ಮೈನಸ್, ದಿಸ್ ಎನ್ಓ ಟು ಮೈನಸ್ ಆಗಿ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದಟ್ ಅಟ್ಯಾಕಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದಿಸ್ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್, ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಮಿಥೈಲ್ ನೈಟ್ರೇಟ್. ಇಫ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಅಟ್ಯಾಕ್, ಇಫ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಅಟ್ಯಾಕ್ ಎ ಜಿ ಸಿ ಎನ್, ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಎ ಜಿ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸಿ ಎನ್ ಮೈನಸ್, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯೋಫೈಲ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಟ್ಯಾಕಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದಿಸ್, ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಸಿ ಎಸ್ ತ್ರೀ ಸಿ ಎನ್. ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಅಟ್ಯಾಕ್, ವಾಟ್ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಸೋ ಮೆನಿ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್, ಯು ಅಟ್ಯಾಕ್ ಎನ್ ಎ ಓ ಆರ್ ಸೋಡಿಯಂ ಅಲ್ಕಾಕ್ಸೈಡ್, ದಿಸ್ ಎನ್ ಎ ಓ ಆರ್ ಮೈನಸ್ ಅಟ್ಯಾಕಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದಿಸ್ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್, ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಸಿ ಎಸ್ ತ್ರೀ ಓ ಆರ್, ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಎಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್, ದೇ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಎಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್. ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ ಟೈಪ್, ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಸೋ ಮೆನಿ ಟೈಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯೋಫಿಲಿಕ್ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಷನ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್. ಓಕೆ, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್, ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯೋಫಿಲಿಕ್ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಷನ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ವಿ ಅಗ್ರಿ ಫಾರ್ ದಟ್. ಹೌ ದಿಸ್ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯೋಫಿಲಿಕ್ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಷನ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್, ದೇ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಅಟ್ ಆಲ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್. ನೋಡಿ, ಯಾವುದೇ ಒಂದು ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಕ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಇರ್ತದ ಇದು ನಾವು ಹೇಳ್ದಂಗೆ ಈಸಿಲಿ ಆಗುದಿಲ್ಲ. ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಸೋ ಮೆನಿ, ಇಟ್ ಇನ್ವಾಲ್ವ್ಸ್ ದ ಫಾಲ್ ಮೆಕ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್. ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದಟ್ ಮೆಕ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್? ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಮೀನ್ ಬೈ ದಿಸ್ ಮೆಕ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್? ಮೆಕ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಸಿಂಪ್ಲಿ ದಟ್ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ ಬೈ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನಿ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್. ದಿಸ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಸರಿ, ದಿಸ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್, ಹೌ ದಿಸ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್, ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ವಾಲ್ವ್ ಇನ್ ದಟ್. ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ದಿ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಡಿಟೇಲ್, ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ ಬೈ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ ಡಿಟೇಲ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡಿಂಗ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಮೆಕ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್. ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಗೋ ಫಾರ್ ಅ ಮೆಕ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ ಫಾರ್ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯೋಫಿಲಿಕ್ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಷನ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್. And this one thing you see here, these nucleophilic substitution reactions are involved in the mechanism two types. It involved in the two types of mechanism. The mechanisms are mechanism of nucleophilic substitution reaction. Mechanism of this nucleophilic substitution reactions are two types. The mechanism of nucleophilic substitution reactions are how many types? Two types. One is called as mono molecular nucleophilic substitution reaction. Monomolecular nucleophilic substitution reaction. And next one more is called as bimolecular nucleophilic substitution reaction. You see here, these nucleophilic substitution reactions involved in the mechanism. That mechanism, in two ways it will be takes place. The first way of this nucleophilic substitution reactions are monomolecular nucleophilic substitution, and the second way is bimolecular nucleophilic substitution reaction. What is mean? These monomolecular nucleophilic substitution reactions were denoted by the symbol SN1, and this bimolecular nucleophilic substitution reactions are called SN2. Therefore, these nucleophilic substitution reactions are takes place in two types of mechanism, that is SN1 mechanism, and one more is called as SN2 mechanism. In this session, we have to discuss about both SN1 as well as SN2 reaction. But before that, first we have to go for SN2 mechanism. What is mean by SN2 mechanism? That SN2 mechanism is the name what itself indicates, that SN2. And SN1. What is mean by SN2 mechanism? I will discuss. SN2. SN2 means, what is that SN2? Nucleophilic substitution reaction by bimolecule. Bimolecules are involved. What is mean by this bi? Bi means indicate what? I will tell you. First, bimolecular nucleophilic substitution reaction. What is mean by this? You see here, this name itself, that these nucleophilic, these reactions involved in the reaction. For example, I will take one methyl bromide. This methyl bromide, whenever reactions with NaOH, In this, what happens? These OH minus attacking to this carbon, therefore it forms methyl hydroxide plus NaBr. You see here, in this reaction, what happens? These OH minus are attacking to this carbon. But this mechanism we have to understand. This reaction is an example for the SN2 reaction. This is an example for SN2 reaction. But what happens? This reaction depends upon two molecules. This reaction depends upon how many molecules? Two molecules. What is that? The reaction depends upon both the reactant, both the starting material, as well as nucleophile. Reaction depends upon reactant as well as a nucleophile. Therefore, it is called as a reactant and it is called as nucleophile. Therefore, the rate of reaction depends upon concentration of both the reactant as well as the concentration of the nucleophile. ನೋಡ್ರಿ, ದಿಸ್ SN2 ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಎದರ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಡಿಪೆಂಡ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತದೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಬೋತ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಮತ್ತು ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯೋಫೈಲ್. ಯಾವ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯೋಫೈಲ್ ಅಟ್ಯಾಕ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆಯಲ್ಲ, ವಿಚ್ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯೋಫೈಲ್ ಇಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಅಟ್ಯಾಕ್ ಟು ದಿಸ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟ್, ದಟ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಇನ್ವಾಲ್ವ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಮೆಕ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್. ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ ದಿಸ್ SN2 ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೆಕ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ ಇನ್ವಾಲ್ವ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಬೋತ್ ಆರ್ ಇಟ್ ಡಿಪೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಏನು, ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಯಾವ್ದ್ರ ಮೇಲೆ ಡಿಪೆಂಡ್ ಆಗೈತಿ, ಯಾವ್ದ್ರ ಮೇಲೆ ಅದು ಅವಲಂಬನೆ ಆಗಿತ್ತು ಅಂದ್ರೆ, ದಿಸ್ SN2 ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಮೆಕ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ ಡಿಪೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಅಪಾನ್ ಬೋತ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯೋಫೈಲ್. ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಟೂ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದೇರ್, ರೈಟ್? Therefore, this is called as bimolecular. Bimolecular. Why this is called bimolecular? This is bimolecular because of due to this nucleophilic substitution reaction depends upon two molecule. What is that? One is called reactant, one more is called as nucleophile. That's very important. I will discuss with you. What is this mechanism? How this reaction and this reaction takes place? We have to understand step by step how it is depends upon two molecule. Okay, you see here, students, this is what methyl group, methyl chloride. In this methyl chloride, we are going to attack NaOH. In this NaOH, this is what nucleophile, OH minus N. This OH minus is not at all attacking directly. ನೋಡ್ರಿ, ಈ ಸಿಎಲ್ ಮೈನಸ್ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಹೊರಗಡೆ ಹೋಗ್ಬೇಕು ಓ ಎಚ್ ಮೈನಸ್ ಅಟ್ಯಾಕ್ ಆಗ್ಬೇಕಂದ್ರೆ, ಈ ಓ ಎಚ್ ಮೈನಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಅಟ್ ಆಲ್ ಅಟ್ಯಾಕ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ. ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಹೆಲೋಜನ್ ಇರ್ತದಲ್ಲ ಅದೇ ಒಂದು ಫೇಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ, ಅದೇ ಒಂದು ದಿಕ್ಕಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಬಂದು ಓ ಎಚ್ ಮೈನಸ್ ಅಟ್ಯಾಕ್ ಆಗಲ್ಲ. ದಿಸ್ ಡಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಅಟ್ಯಾಕ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಟು ಸೇಮ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಹೆಲೋಜನ್ ಐಟಮ್. ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟೆಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಟ್ಯಾಕಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದಿ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಸೈಡ್. ಓ ಎಚ್ ಮೈನಸ್ ಅಟ್ಯಾಕ್ ಟು ದಿ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಸೈಡ್. ವೈ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್? ಯು ಸಿ ಹಿಯರ್, ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಸೈಜ್ ಆಫ್ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್, ಬಟ್ ಹೆಲೋಜನ್ ಈಸ್ ಸಮ್ ವಾಟ್ ಬಿಗ್ಗರ್ ಸೈಜ್. There is no space to attack OH minus here, but there will be large space is there, right? This H to H, there will be large space, therefore this nucleophile attack will be easily, then this halogen is living outside. Therefore, if it attack directly and it is living outside as a substituent, therefore due to this steric hindrance, this nucleophile is not attacking to front side, but it attack to back side. And then after that, what happens? See here, this is the first attacking of nucleophile to the back side, not attacked to the front side. Then after that, this is what a wedge. This is what a wedge. You see here, this is OH and this is Cl. You see here, in this state, what happened in this next step, this Cl minus is not at all completely removed 100%, and this is not OH and attack to this carbon 100%. Initially what happened, this is dotted lines indicate that it is easily slowly breaking down, and it is slowly formation of new bond. It is slowly breaking down and it is slowly formation of new bond. This state is called as whatever, in which state both the nucleophile attacking to the carbon, both the nucleophile, I'm telling, this Cl and as well as OH, both the nucleophile is there, therefore this state is called as a transition state. this state is called as what a transition state. In this transition state is the one in which both the nucleophile are attacking to the carbon atom. Then after some times this nucleophile is entirely removed 100% and this OH minus attacking, therefore this is what H, next one more H, and this OH is attacking to this side. You see here, from this initially, this chlorine is in right side. Chlorine means that nucleophile is in right side. But after seeing this reaction, after seeing this mechanism, this OH minus is in left side. Initially the molecule is right side. After that it is going to left side. This molecule shape, the molecule direction will be changed. The molecular structure will be changed. Initially it is like that, left side, right side, and after attacking to this is Cl minus. You see here, this H plus are there in this side, left side, but you are going to the right side. This nucleophile is right side, but here nucleophile is left side. Entirely the molecule is going to, if it is initial hingitandra, after that attacking to, it going to like this, it will be change its direction. Initially it is left right side, after that it is going to left side, and it is called as inversion product. And this direction change, it is called as what a inversion. What is mean by inversion? Inversion means the image change model. You know, mirror notivala itta hinga the opposite torus. This is called as mirror image, inversion. This is first time explained by the scientist, and this is called as Molden inversion. Therefore, this is called as Molden inversion. Entirely the molecule change its position as well as direction. Therefore, this is called as Molden inversion product. In SN2, which type of product will form? Well, that is Molden inversion. And one more thing. These all SN2 reaction takes place in only one step reaction. You see here, this is one step reaction. If it is nucleophile attacking to here, and it is slowly breaking down formation of new bond, breaking down old bond and formation of new bond, and easily it is formation of a new bond. Therefore, this whole mechanism takes place in only one step. Therefore, this SN2 reaction is one step mechanism. And it is Molden inversion. Entirely product change after the permission. It is shape change after, therefore it is called as Molden inversion. Next, after that this concept I will go for the what are the factors affecting on this, it depends upon. How the man is depend on the SN2 reaction. Hang now move the conditions come into that. What is the conditions you have to understand that first? SN1 reactions, this SN2 reaction. What is this? This SN2 reaction depends upon. SN2 reaction depends upon some conditions. What are the conditions for this SN2 reaction? First one. Or conditions? Conditions anukita factors affecting on that. Before that, this conditions that factors affecting on factors affecting on SN2 reaction. Factors affecting on SN2 reaction. These SN2 reactions depends upon some factors. What are that first one? Go for the first factor. Steric crowding. Steric crowding. In this reaction, what happened? You see here, in this methyl is there. Initially, this is what Cl minus is there. If OH minus is attacking, this OH minus, the oxide, if it is attaching, this attacking, if this molecule is smaller, no problem, this reaction takes place easily. If they are going to bigger, even though it is molecule hang attack by kill nucleophile, therefore steric crowding and you know other size, bigger size after steric, you know, steric crowding. Steric crowding is easily attacked. therefore if the molecule ಈಗ ಎಲ್ಲಾ ಕಡೆ ಹೆಚ್ಚು ಹೆಚ್ಚಿತ್ತು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಮಿಥೈಲ್ ಕ್ಲೋರೈಡ್. ಒಂದೇ ಇಫ್ ಸೋ ಯು ಸಿ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಮಿಥೈಲ್ ಕ್ಲೋರೈಡ್ ಇಫ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟೆಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಒನ್ ಎಚ್ ಇಫ್ ಅಟ್ಯಾಕಿಂಗ್ ಒನ್ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ಕೈಲ್ therefore it is called as primary. After that if this H R one more R this is L then this there are two alkyl group are there it is secondary. If both the side all this side alkyl groups are there then it is called as what a tertiary. In this reactions what happen this alkyl group size will be increases. There are two alkyl group there are three alkyl group. How the number of alkyl group increasing it is very difficult to OH minus attacking. It is very difficult to attacking the OH minus ion. Therefore this SN1 reaction depends or follows the order. First one this is methyl carbocation is very fast than that of primary, next than that of secondary, next than that of tertiary carbocation. It follows the order of the primary methyl, otherwise methyl halides, primary halides, secondary halides and tertiary. First one should be carbon is of the order methyl, primary halides, secondary halides, next one tertiary halides. This is what order factors affect, depends the factors affecting an SN2 reaction. If it is S methyl group it is very fast, if it is CH3 it is very slow. Why I am discussing these points you see here students, this is what very important. This is methyl chloride and one more thing CH3 CH. This is isopropyl chloride. They are asked previously need CET question. There are so many asking questions comes from this organic chemistry. You see here this is methyl chloride and next this is isopropyl chloride. Among them which is involved SN2 reaction fastly? Which is involved SN2 reaction fastly? They are asking question. Yaudra fast aagthaithe. You see here in this two alkyl groups are there. Attacking of this there is no any alkyl group, there will be only hydrogen is there. It is very difficult to attack OH minus ion, whatever it may be, nucleophile attack aagbekandre illi crowding baala aithe, jaga baala aithe, illi space illa, therefore nucleophile idak attack aagbekandre illi ello abstract aagutte, therefore it is very difficult isopropyl. Therefore this is what this is secondary carbon, but this is methyl, therefore this methyl chloride involved very fastly the nucleophilic substitution reaction, that is SN2 reaction. Therefore this is the first factor atmospheric crowding. Next one you see here ability of living group is here CH3Cl reactions with OH minus ion. Next is CH3Iodine reactions with OH minus ion. Among them which is also gives a product CH3OH and this is also gives CH3OH. This here both the side this is also CH3OH. In this both the halogens are going outside living group, both are living group. In among them which is attacking very fastly, yav the best living group ClO matu iodine, that is very important. We learn that this iodine is very larger group and it is very smaller group compared to this chlorine. Iodine is very bigger, there will be very weak bond is there, very weak bond. If it is very weak bond means it is breaks very easily. That's why I discussed in the nature of CX bond, carbon halogen bond. This is very weak a bond, it cuts, it breaks very easily, therefore nucleophile attacking to this halogen very fast. This compound is very fast alkyl halides, therefore this halides the follows fluorine less than that of chlorine, next than that of bromine, next that of iodine, therefore alkyl iodide, therefore alkyl fluoride, alkyl chloride, alkyl bromides, next than that of alkyl iodide. Therefore the order of nucleophilic substitution reaction, alkyl iodide is easily involved in the SN2, next then that of alkyl bromide, alkyl chloride, next that of alkyl fluoride. This is what are nucleophilic substitution reactions and leaving groups involved in the reaction. Next one, I use in the strong nucleophile. Using the strong nucleophile. Next, using strong nucleophile. This is why I am discussing this point. Such questions are very important in your NEET and CET. Why they are asking? If ethyl bromide, next one is called as methyl iodide. Among them, which is highest rate of reaction? Highest rate of reactions in SN2 reaction. Rate of reaction means what? Which reaction involves fast? Which reaction involves fast means this iodine is leaving very fastly. Therefore, this is what involved in highest rate of reaction compared to this. Understood? They are asking, there are so many questions arising from this concept. That's why I am discussing. Next one, using the strong nucleophile. Strong nucleophile means what? Use RCN minus, this RCN, next R. There are so many reactions, there are so many compounds are there. HCN. There are so many strong nucleophile is there. If you use strong nucleophile, these compounds are leaving very fastly. That's why we have to use. Next one, fourth one, solvents. A solvent used in this. In this reaction, this nucleophilic reaction, we have to use aprotic solvent. Why they are used aprotic solvent? If you use a protic solvent, means they are intermediate. They are going to involved in the reaction. Therefore, they are going to disturb the reaction. We have to use aprotic like DMSO. Dimethyl sulfoxide. This is what structure. Dimethyl sulfoxide. If don't use like water. Water means it consists of H plus OH minus, right? But in this CH3, this is not, it does not give H plus again. Don't confuse. It does not give H plus again, but it only methyl group. Like H plus OH minus. This is a protic solvent. But don't use the protic solvent, use the aprotic solvent. These are what are some important factors involved in the SN2 reaction. Next, we have to go for SN1 reaction.